Okay, these are the instructions for the rolling ball lab. Remember that this video is meant to give you some supplementary tips and advice for setting up and conducting the lab and is not going to replace the instructions. So please make sure you've read all the instructions and completed all the additional activities before beginning the experiment. Before you get started, make sure you have all your materials. You're going to need your lab instructions, your data table. Of course, you'll need your composition book and your pencil as well. The lab materials are going to consist of masking tape, two stopwatches, a meter stick, and a tennis ball you'll have to get from me, okay? So the purpose of this lab is to measure or observe the motion of a rolling ball. In this case, you're going to be using a tennis ball. And in order to observe the motion of the rolling ball, you're actually going to measure the time it takes to travel across the floor for 5 meters. So the first thing you're going to do is set up your track. I'm going to move my computer down so you guys can see what I'm going to do. And I'm on the lab stations, but you're going to do this on the floor. I'm just doing it because it's a little easier for me. So what you're going to do is you're going to actually mark a starting line, and you need to make sure you have 5 meters of uninterrupted space. So it's really important that you measure as accurately as possible so that your times and speeds are as accurate as possible. So I'm going to set up this fake distance here, because obviously my lab tables aren't 5 meters. I'm going to mark my starting point at 0. I'm going to measure to the halfway point, which is 5 meters, is going to be 2.5 meters. I'm going to put a piece of tape there. And then I'm going to mark the finish line, which is 5 meters. Okay, so finish line's 5 meters. Can you see that? Okay, and then I don't need my meter sticks anymore. Or my tape. And then what I'm gonna do is you need 3 people for this lab, 2 people to be timers and 1 person to be a ball roller. The person that's gonna be rolling the ball, you're gonna want someone that has a fair amount of control, maybe a little bit of skill, hand-eye coordination for rolling, because you really want the rolls to be as consistent as possible. The timers are going to be collecting one time each. The first person, both timers are going to start the timer when the balls leave the starting line. The first timer is going to stop their timer when it crosses the midpoint. The second timer is going to stop theirs when it crosses the finish line. So you end up with 2 times. Then you're going to do some calculations with speeds from each point of the track. A couple things to keep in mind is, again, just like the incline to roll lab, if you mess up on the timing, please redo it. It only takes a few seconds to do the measurements. So if you did it incorrectly, really important to redo it so you get good data. The second thing is with the rolling, again, to pick someone who is good at rolling a ball, I don't know, is to not roll it like a bowling ball where it's up in the air and it bounces on the ground. You want it to be down on the ground and roll it from there so that you don't get any bounce or throw in the beginning. It's just a roll. That'll help keep the speeds consistent throughout the rolls. The last thing is that you're going to be asked to do 1 slow roll and 1 fast roll. For the fast roll, don't give in to the temptation to roll it as fast as you can, because you're going to outroll the timing ability of your timers. They just are not going to have a good enough reaction time to get those times. So what I would do is start with a really slow roll and then go faster from there. It's going to give you your best data, and that's what we want from this lab. So good luck, and let me know if you have any questions.